output. So these two things play a very major role on the success. So this one, what he says, you go by the hypothesis, that is the idea. That is the one experiment bond or experiment model there is. What is that? Build and product. So what is the thing we are going to reach to the product? Measure, data. Now these days, the importance of data is very much. If you have a very good data and very right data, then we can learn on that one. We can take a knowledge on that one. And then we can go for a pivotal. And then for ideas, then I can build. And then the product comes in a picture. Now, if the data is wrong, suppose. If the data is wrong, then total learning is wrong. The output is wrong. So the measure and data, these two is a very, very basic thing when we go for entrepreneurship or any startup or any type of company process. So these are the four steps, very important steps, which we have to think when we go for the entrepreneurship. A revision, the product building part. What is the product building part? First, we have to think a design. Design thinking, first we have to think a design. So to make a design, there is a methodology. Lot of methodologies are there. So which method we are going to use to make it a design thinking? So is a method of emulating strategies designers use during the design process? Yes, they are using. The design thinking process is something very complicated and very, very powerful. If I go for any startup, or if I go for any type of institution building or company building. So inspiration is the first part when we take it in a design thinking process. Inspiration, from where the inspiration comes, who are the stakeholders for this inspiration, then ideation. With that inspiration, what are the ideas I have developed? What are the ideas my team has been developed? Next is implementation. Now, the ideas, how to implement, how many ideas have been implemented, how to implement. This is the process. So inspiration, ideation, implementation. These are the thing what we are going to do in the design thinking process. And this is very complicated process. Complicated process in the sense, is not a one man doing process. So this design thinking process is based on inspiration, ideation, implementation. So what is design? Design is once the problem is, we have find it one problem, then immediately I have to see whether there is a solution for that problem or not. If suppose there is no solution for that problem, I am not going to pivotal. I am not going to a model process. First of all, I have to see whether the problem have a solution or not. For that, when the problem is there, if the solution is there, we go for a mathematical modeling. We go for modeling. So problem finding is the first thing after the situation and undesired, then the problem solving. And then we are going for a flow for inspired or for the situations or for the design type of things. So what we say, design as a known system, as a service, product, building, or artifice, changing existing situations into preferred ones. That is known as design. Changing existing situations into preferred ones. That is Herbert Simon in 1981, he has told that this is the meaning of design. Suppose now I am going to say, let us design. Design means what? Whatever is the present and what is going to be a future. That is the design I need there. Okay. Now, the design involves, what is that? Task clarification. The task clarification is a very, very important point. If suppose there is no clarity in the task, the total product is failure. The total product is failure because the people is not understanding what is your task, how they are going to give an output. So the task clarification is very important. Who will give this task clarification? The client who is going to speak about a problem, who want the product, he has to clarify what task he want with what specification or what is the information he need. Okay, that is the thing. Then Conceptual design is the next level, which is our part, which is a part from what you say startups or entrepreneur. The conceptual design is going to make or to made basis on the task clarification. So embodiment design is we are going to embedded in the specific constructions or layout like that, if you see example, and detailed design. So rough design and detailed design, you learn like that. So rough design and detailed design. So these are the designing stages when we start a one thing. So there are four activities that occur iteratively during each stage of design. What is that? Portfolio sketches, what you know, the portfolio, you have heard all students, is a very popular word. What is your portfolio or what is the portfolio? So evaluate, modify, select, generate. What does it mean? Generate, evaluate, modify, select. Now these days, select is a part of the customer. Select is a part of the customer. So the design, whatever I am going to make it, a customer is going to select that one, that I need this. And suppose a company people want a cell phone, which is very recent now. So you are going to make a design for them. They are going to select the design, which design they want for that product. So the select is totally customer. That is, they have, and now these days, the customer or you say stakeholders satisfaction level is in top. We don't know what they are going to ask in that one and how they are going to ask. We doesn't know. So the selection is totally on the customer, and based on the customer, we are going to generate. And one more thing, we are not going to think that what we have, what the customer need. We have to think that what now these days the customers and the people are going to expect. With that expectation, we have to generate, or we have to make a design, and we have to make a production. So generate, evaluate, modify, and select. So this is the one of the process. So design is creative activity. The total thing is where all of you, I think you know, when you go for a design for a house, so it's a creative activity. He comes with one design, and he will show to the house owner that these are the designs. Which one you are going to select? Please tell me if any modification. So determines the life cycle of the product. Design determines the life cycle of the product, and in turn the impact on the environment of the product. Both are important. So present facts to future possibilities. These are the things what. So when you see in the design, a very popular book, in that there is a lot of quotations by the big people. What about the design? So now the design development, how we are going to develop one design, it has a phase manner, and total design when it completes, we say life cycle of a design. Life cycle of a design. What is that? We are going to say production, distribution. Now use, after use, materialize. Use, after use, materialize. What is that? Waste is there, and after use is there, materialization is there, and if you see the left side, distribution and production is there. It means an important concept where the whole life cycle, that is input and output exchange process between the environment and the whole set of processes that entail our the entire lifetime of a given product is considered during the design development. Now, how to access a design, good or bad? Indicators, way of telling how much can the system affect. What is that? Impacts on human health, ecosystem and resources, toxicity or human toxicity, carbon footprint, acidification, water depletion, ozone depletion. These are all the things what is going to impact, or we are going to consider. We have to see whether it is impacts on health or ecosystem or resources. These are all things we have to think when we are going for any entrepreneurship, or when we are going to say to get a startup, any startups. So what are the design methods? So if you see the design methods, conceptual design, embodiment design, and detailed design. Conceptual design is a rough sketch, which for concept we can make it. Embedded design means is we put it in on a pen and paper that this is the embodiment design. And detailed design is you can see now these days CAD CAM is there. You can use the CAD CAM to make it a design in a colorful model or 3D model and so on. So that is the design methodology. Now, the stakeholders, who are the stakeholders? Any person, organization, social group, or society at large that has a stake, that is vital interest or concern in a business project or its activities. So for if you see the stakeholders, see material is directly involved, raw material suppliers and like that. When we start something, we are going to be bond or connect with some suppliers. So material means raw material. For example, suppose I am building a house. So material means cement, concrete, iron, this type of things. So materials. When we say production, production is innovators. Innovators are a production. And when I say use, users, who is going to use that one? So these are the things what we are going to see in the life cycles, and these are going to impact a major role or make a major effect on your startup point or the initial part of the startup or entrepreneur level. Now, suppose safety, when I use a workshop, so I want to think that what type of safeties I have to use it or what for my workers or for my engineers or for the company. Next, machine specification training. It means which type of training, which type of skills we have to make a train to our workers, our laborers. Repeatability. How much is the repeatability is there? Provision for differently abled innovators and users, affordability, training for different age and gender groups, cultural acceptability. These are all the things what we are going to make it one chart, and profitable stakeholders we are going to take it from that one, giving one questionnaire or one one chart such that we see the score. What is the prioritization? For example, I, U, V, W, F, these are all the things. So a basis on the marks, we are going to see which I have to be given a priority. Okay. So a MET matrix is a MET. So the previous, what I have shown you the table, it is known as MET matrix. MET matrix is a tool to analyze the product impact on the environment throughout its life cycle. So these are all, you can see this one anywhere you can get it, this MET matrix for any type of company. So general, so when I say there is the impact of towers for the cell phone, there is the impact of the vehicles which are moving, that is pollution. So these are the things what we are going to see and how is going to impact on the thing. So this all analysis we are going to put it with us. The MET matrix is a means of organizing an analysis of all the type of environment problem that a product could cause. So based on that report, we are going to see how to get rid of this one and how to make it our startup or our company or our entrepreneurship in the good level. So key output of task clarifying is a list of the requirements, yellow R, list of requirement. For example, if I want to make something, what is our list of requirement is there? I have to prepare one list. So requirements are noted either as a demands requirements that must be met and wishes requirements that we are optional or desirable. But when you see the high companies, this demand and wishes both combinedly, they are going to speak. They doesn't compromise on this one. Otherwise, what people do, they say that, okay, demands are okay. Wishes, I do not want, just you complete my demand. But some companies, they doesn't compromise on the wishes. Yes, I wishes like this. My client should be enjoy my product like that. So requirements noted as wish are further assigned. What is that? High wishes, medium, low. For example, when I say a student in a class very high wishes that he should be 10 out of 10 grade or something like that. So that is high. Medium means okay, fine, 9 or 9.5 is okay, fine. Or medium 8 or okay. So low, okay, if you bring a 6, I am satisfied. So this is the level of the satisfaction or priorities or the wishes what we are going to say here. So conceptual design specifies the path to the principal solution. What is that? Task clarification, conceptual design, embodiment design, detailed design. So this is the thing, and between that we get it the list of requirement. Concept is the final selected solution, that is principal solution, from amongst the other solution. This all varies from product to product, person to person. Okay, so design concept, list of requirement, what is that? Abstraction of problem. The first thing, the problem should be abstracted. It means we have to read it in all the ways, all the angles, what is the problem? Then I have to go, this problem, what is the overall function? What is the overall function? What is the function structure of that problem? Then we have to go, how to study this type of function structure? What is the methodology? Brainstorming method. If you see the Six Sigma or reliability part, you see these are the things, keywords used in the reliability. What is the method? Brainstorming. Okay. So working principle is physical effect, Matt Gum characteristics. Okay. And then it comes to the method. Morphological chart is there. Through chart, we are going to show what is the method to show the total problem in as a principal solution. So these are the things what we are going to use, that is known as conceptual design or conceptual design thinking. What is the aim of morphological chart method, MCM? To generate complete range of alternate solution for a product and hence to widen the search for potential nearby solution. So the procedure for the method is as follows. What is that? List of features. List must not be long. List must be comprehensive. For each feature, list the means of solution. One might list only existing ideas. One might list existing the new ideas. Draw up a chart containing all the possible sub-solutions. And then you are going to see or identify feasible combinations of sub-solutions. Once the feasible combination of sub-solutions we are identifying, then the total number of possible combinations may be very large. This is permutation combination we are applying when we go for the total type of combination. So such strategies may have to be guided by constraints or criteria. Okay. Now, see, these are the things. For example, if you see about the conceptual, see the features and means. What are the, see, I have marked all the things. Support, wheel, driven wheel, electric, belt, rail, brakes, screw, remote control. The rest of the things I am not going to touch because it is not related to this one. Now, when I say features and means means wheels, driven wheels, electric wheels, belt, rails, brakes, screw, remote control. Now, from remote control, this all things can be controlled. So this is the means. This is the means what we aim. So compare alternative design proposal on the basis of their performance against differentially weighted objectives. Now, if you see this one, those who have studied the OR, operation research, assign weighted problems. You have seen the weighted problems and so on in the operation research. If you are a student of any mechanical branch or any applied mathematics branch, that operation research is one of the subjects in which we are going to assign assignment problem and we are going to assign weight here. So relative scores for the solution variant, top scorer wins. So we are going to use the assignment problem to find out who is the top, who is the loser. Okay, what is the procedure for finding this one? So what I told you, the concept is same thing. We use a operation research method. And while doing that, we go for a matrix to make it a matrix. The rows and columns are going to be given as a C1, C2, C3, and KI A1, A2, A3. The total sum, what we see in the right side, what we have to see, this assignment problem, step by step, how to give it to the each and every box. First row, first column, first element, how to get it. So this, we are going to build it from this one. And then feedback to design and manufacture. Is it enough for design and manufacture? No. Considering and thinking about issues far ahead. Now the number of issues, when I am going to say this is the design, once the design has been formed, I have to think whether this design is going to be a danger for the world or it is beneficial for the world. Or what are the issues with this design? So starting right during the design phase, obsolescence management is there, in which promote and support, what is that? Reuse, recycle, repurposing. Reusing, recycling, repurposing. Recollecting the waste from their system, product and service. Collaboration, the communication among what you say stakeholders. Complement and fulfill function for the others. Functioning like an ecosystem. Very, very important point. Now these days, whenever anyone is going to talk, they are going to speak that ecosystem. Ecosystem is a very powerful word. Now, what is the validation? We are going to do business. Okay, fine. We have going to be a business model. What is the validation of our business? Validating our business or validating your business model hypothesis. Okay. So if I had asked the people, very, very important point Henry Ford had told, what he told, if I had asked people what they want, they would have said faster horses. If you ask someone, which type of car you want, whether he is a beggar or if he is a middle person or if he is a high person, he will say Audi car I want. Fastest horses, Audi car I want. But so what Henry Ford has told, don't ask, you find it or you find out what a customer need. Now these days, what a customer need, those the people, what they are doing now, they are as a success business person. So identifying and doing the assumptions. So problem, customer, solution fit. The problem is given by the customer, and the solution fit we are going to see is what is the best solution for that problem. If it is what you say optimized, we are going to stop there. If it is not optimized, we are going for the iteration process to get it a best solution fit. Now, the second is product market fit. Whether this product is market fit or not. For example, if suppose in Tirupati, there is a very, very small roads. Okay, suppose, and a person is advised, you take it a car of very big length and width. So what will happen? So that product cannot be fit in there, cannot be parked also. So what is the next alternate? I have to see for a product which can be fit for my house, for my parking system, for my easy on-road. So that product or market fit, which type of thing now these days we are going. So market is fit for this product or not, that I have to scale. Then we go for scaling. What type of scale? Scale is how much risk is involved, how much inputs are required, how much money we have to afford for this one, and the customer, what the best price we can give to the customer. These are all scaling we have to do there. Now, so for this all things, I have to create the hypothesis. I have to create the hypothesis. If you torture the data long enough, it will confess. It means when data is there, in the beginning itself, I told you, data is a very, very important point. Data is a very, very important point. If I have a data, and if it is a correct data, the data will give a very good output. and you play with the data, you torture the data. The data speaks a lot of things. We should learn how to extract from the data, how to make confess the data. So if you torture the data long enough, it will confess. There is no doubt about it. Now, what is the next process? Specific repeatable action will result in. Specific or repeatable action will result in. Expected measurable customer action, changing to focus on subscription-based model, will result in. A 10% increase in customer conversation. Okay, conversions. So what we do that we talk to the customer, we convince we convince for our product, but he have his own mindset for that product. He has taken a survey from 10 people and he has made his own concept in his mind. So these are all the things he is going to see. So we should have a marketing strategy, and we should have results, all results, whatever he is going to check or with whatever he is going to compare. This everything should be with us. Okay. So business model validation. If I see the business model validation, customer discovery, business model design, business model validation. So once the design is made, we go for the validation. So validation, value proper, channel CRM, and cost op. So just now I told you about the cost. If suppose I am going to say, I have my own startup company of mobile company, suppose, and I am going to say, I'm going to bring or launch one mobile, which is 90,000 per piece. Who is going to purchase? Because by 6,000, 7,000, everyone is getting a mobile phone. So it's a cost, whatever features you are going to put it, all the features with less or something good for their eyes, they are getting in 5,000 and 6,000. Why he go for 90,000? And next is, if I go for 5 and 6, after 1 year, again, I can go for next one with new features. Why I take it for 90 and I put it that in for some years. So that is the strategy from the customer. So problem and solution fit. Gain creator, product, service, painkiller. So these are the things where the lot of things is going to be effect. What is that? Painkillers means a lot of pain is there when one product is going to be some miss out or some product is not going to be up to expectation. So lot of pain is there. So for that, to kill that pain. So what is that? Gains. Gains will kill the pain. Okay. So that is the thing what we are going to do here. You know, I think if the students know the Sholay movie was made in 1972 or 73, Sholay. And when GPCP, both are brothers, GPCP has gone for the production, the total property they invest in the Sholay movie. But when the Sholay is launched, the first 1 month, 1 week, there is no people in the cinema hall. No one is going to enter in the cinema hall. The cinema was 4 hours. It's a very big movie. 4 hours. No one is going for to see the cinema hall. The next, what they have thought? Yes, we are ruined. We are in loss. Very lot of pain for 2 months. After that, after 2 months, when a houseful is started for that movie, Till now, if a Sholay is going to come in any Tirupati cinema hall, again, it is houseful. That is the craze of that movie. And after that, the total movie is for years, it was houseful. And you know, for generally movies, people use a posters, wall posters for advertise. For this movie, there is no question of poster. On walls they have make it through horticulture and like that permanently it should be a Sholay poster. See the beauty. So that gains kill the total pain. And now also till death also GPCP has told, that Sholay is the only movie, and that movie is sufficient for my life. So this is the satisfaction level. This is the, that was the gain for them. So when testing customer hypothesis, when we see on a scale of 0 to 10, how big of a pain is this to be? Now testing solutions, when we say, so if I get a satisfaction level 9 or 10, I say, yes, I am satisfied. If I say 8 or below, I say, no, I am not going to satisfy. If I am a good startup or if I am a good entrepreneur, we should not compromise with the quality. So if 8 or below, I say, no, it is not satisfied. Again, let us rebuild our design, or let us go to back to our design and see what is going on. In some cases, some companies, they doesn't allow 9 also as a satisfaction. They want 10 as a satisfaction level. So innovators canvas. What is the innovator canvas? Key resources, key matrix, brand, then the value, and a lot of parameters are there. When I say innovators canvas is there. So in every stage, when you see in this one, every stage, there is a risk factor. There is a risk factor. And while making this chart, I have to pay very attention. What is, for example, in this total chart, value proportion is there. Value proportion is there. Value proportion. What does it mean? It means if I see, value means whatever is the product, whether it is selling or not, that is my aim. No. What is the value? Whether it is value proposition means whether it is helpful to the society or not. These are also things. Now these days, company is going to inculcate in their design. Societal need is very, very important. The product should be integrate with the societal need. So that is also one point. So the innovator's canvas is like this. Okay. What about the payment? How much they have to pay? How much they can afford? Whether it is for middle, whether it is for lower level, whether it is for upper level. So this all things we are going to see in the canvas. Okay. Now this is just one example. 3-1-2-1 is the one flow chart or one of the customers solves a known customer's problem. Okay, so one of the known customer, he has given a problem and the company has solved. So customers are willing to pay for it. Once the customer is satisfied, they are going to pay for, they are going to give their willingness whether I have to pay for it or not. We have verified a channel and we see this profitability and sustainability, this is a very important point when we are going for the verification. We can run the business profitable and sustainability. Okay. So ideas validation. This is a very important point, not product validation. Product validation is the final part. Ideas validation is ground level, in the idea level. So number of ideas are there, and now the all ideas should be validated. And once the ideas is validated, then we are going to say it should be in the next level. It should be in the next level. And then we are going to see, once, if suppose ideas is not validated, then what will happen? The product will be weak. The product will be weak because you have not consolidated all the ideas. Never stop experimenting. Never stop experimenting. If suppose I stop experimenting, what will happen? I can't get the present need of the society. If I continue the experimenting, I can get if and buts in that one. If I am in startup, I want to work as an entrepreneurship, if I want to come as an industrial person, then never stop experimenting. Now in this process, I suggest audience or participants, this is the best example for the academician or the industry. Suppose I have one industry in oil part, then definitely what I want to do for oil part, I do not depend on the lower engineers or our MDs and so on. So if I am a chairman, if I doesn't have a knowledge on that one, what will happen? Whatever they are going to speak, I have to accept it. So what we are going to do, we are going to acquire a knowledge of, about that product, and then we are going into the product. If suppose I am not going to acquire a knowledge in that part, then the people, whatever they are going to say, I have to accept it. Okay, like that, this Swayam platform, we have to update our subjects. We have to go on experimenting that this subject I am going to study, let us see what is the output. That is the Swayam platform. So from Swayam platform, I now itself also, I choose one subject, I read it and see what is the update, what are the things. If I experiment like this, what will happen? This all things still also I'm going to do it. So getting into product development. Getting into product development. So when I say getting into product development, I have to see, you see the picture here, electronics, mechanical part, and the paste type of parts are also there. So minimum viable product development. This is known as MVP. MVP. So minimum viable product development is a key issue when we are going to speak about any type of product. So MVP is a very important task. Okay. So a significant effort should be there. Requires a lot of people, time and money. If you think you are starting with a developed product that needs to be perfected, you are wrong. So product development is hard work that requires. Therefore, whenever company is going to make a product, they always use a trial before coming to market. It goes for a trial. When it goes for a trial, that trial is, if and buts are there, they are going to rectify and then they are going to launch. For example, this corona vaccine is there. If you are not going for a trial for that vaccine, if you are going to directly use on the human, what will happen? Number of if and buts will be there. So which one will people will prefer? Which those who have completed a total trials, the people will look on that one, or people are going to see towards that one, that type of product. So trial is a very important point. And if I say my product is directly for need, it is perfect. No, it's not like that. So get your product in production at your price goal. The price goal, as I already told you, price is a very important point. If suppose I say, I have one startup as a small hotel or cafe. If suppose my coffee is something 100 rupees and neighbor to me, there is a coffee with some 50 rupees, which they are going to prefer. Definitely they are going to prefer that one when you see the price. But if you see the taste, if both are slight difference. So I go for 50, not for 100. So this price goal is very important when we go for the production type of thing. Do it yourself or find partners. So this is the thing. Either you fix yourself or you go with the partner and decide it what you are going to do it, what you have to do it. Everything from materials to distribution. So if you cannot make it, you cannot sell it. If we cannot make it, we cannot sell it. Till now, if all the participants, whether they are agree with this or not, till we are using a China product, right? Last 2 years up to back, the China products are too much in our market. Why? They are makers, we are users. Now, when the Make in India concept is there by Honorable Prime Minister, when the things are going to make in India itself, then only India is going to sell abroad or here. Then only we can have we can add it in the list of development countries or developed countries. So minimum vibrant MVP development. Minimum vibrant product development. MVP development, what is that? Minimum viable good features to test users. there should be an intersection part. That intersection part is MVP. Okay, minimum viable. Grab a product, the product you want to build. Products and ways. So key part of learning is definition of a MVP. What is minimum visible product? That product which has just those features and not no more that allows you to ship a product that early adopters see. And at least some of whom resonate with pay you money for and start to give you feedback on. So that is known as MVP. Okay. Now, time and money, what we see, get interest, get money, buy yourself time with the thing. What is the MVP? If you see the figure in the left side, see the without any colors, you're seeing the this is MVP. After MVP, I have given that one is the product. For example, when you go to purchase a cake, birthday cake, MVP is a cake what you have ordered. After that, what he makes is all the cream or whatever biscuits and all the things he's going to put it. And when he delivered you, it is a product. What is raw? MVP is just cake which is taken out from the oven. After that, lot of things he is going to do it to make it a product. So that is the way. And what is the best method to see this one? Bootstrap. A way to bootstrap your method. Bootstrap is one of the method to increase your company or startup to a higher level. Okay. And feedback should be always there such that customer can speak which is good, which is bad. And customers should have, you should take a feedback from the customer such that you can improve your quality, if you can improve your product. So what is Dropbox? Not a product, video, sell your design, feature. So what I can say, I am not going to up to a product level. I just sell my design, sell my design, that's all. I just sell my patent. And rest of the things you can do it. So the scientists, the maximum academia do the same thing. What they do, they sell their ideas, they sell their design and features, and the industry is going to purchase and make it as a product. So this consultancy is going, therefore now these days, industries are collaborating with the academia, academic persons. Therefore, the Honorable Prime Minister and all the governments and the new education policy also speaks, whenever there is an industry, definitely there should be some MOU with the academia or academia. If there is an academia, professional type of thing, then there should be tie up with one industry. That is the thing. So types of MVPs, number of types are there. What is that for one example is Google. You see this Google. Identify the key feature you must have and develop for those. You can type here, you can see it. What is that? So single feature is what? Google Dropbox, etc. Number of things are there. Okay. Hardware. Only option is to limit your first release to the absolute minimum of features. Absolute minimum of features. You see the right side, there is an iWatch. So what is the difference? We should know, or we should specify, what is the difference between watch and iPhone, iWatch. What is the difference between watch and iWatch? There should be some special features. It should be weightless. It should be convenient to us. And it should be a very nanosecond type of digitalization. Lot of expectations are there. Okay. So focus on building early success. So what is the key of success? Key of success means it should be not just like other watches, and the features should be totally different and embedded type of thing. So success with minimum vibrant product development, do the step before right, do not go off on tangents, stick to the plan, apply lean product development principles, and then go to the next level. Okay, this is the thing what we are going to make it a success with MVP. If MVP is there, then success is, if you have a good MVP, there is no problem or there is no difficulty to make that MVP as a product. So design for manufacturability. What is overall reaching goal? See the cycle: material selection, testing strategy, standards and protocols, manufacturing strategy, product design. Product design, product intended, both are same. So this is the cycle. In cycle, three major parties: cost, time and scope. Very, very important. If I say, okay, give me money, I will make it your product in 20 years. Who will give you money to make it 20 years? Some people say that, okay, within 1 year, I'm going to give you a, he will blindly give it to him. So scope, scope, I have to explain that these are the scopes, these are the things. And under that, I have to go MOU with that one. When the product comes to the market, I have to check one by one point in the MOU such that we have get it or not. Okay. So process example, including design for manufacturability, idea to design with DFM, testing, manufacturing, 3D models and drawing, DFM analysis, incorporating things are there. So a lot of things we can have it in this one. The product look and feel, how the product look and feel should be there. What is that? Designers have moved from just designing to identify products and building solutions. Applying the principles of design for better user experience. Design has traditionally been associated with aesthetic, but has evolved by to building evolving product portfolios. So patterns always follow from knowledge and expertise. Very, very important. This fourth part. Patterns always follow from knowledge and expertise. Application of design element. So how successful brands have used these elements of design in their product and how you can also do it for yourself. So what are the lines, circles, curved lines, jagged edges? So these are the things what we have to put in our mind. I will show you. See the logo. The first one, Pepsi. Next, BMW. You see the logo. Circle. 3 points I have told you. What is that? Circle, curved lines, jagged edges. Now see, check it, this one. So these are the thing. Mozilla, you have this type of thing. It is Mozilla Fire. So Pepsi, you have that one. BMW is like that. Starbucks coffee is like that given. So whether it is communicating, the symbol should communicate what they want to speak. That is the important point here. And Adidas, Mitsubishi, squares and triangles, stability, balance, efficiency, power law, religion, masculine. So Delta, Mercedes Benz, see all these things. Adidas, their own lines method. Mitsubishi, it is some triangle method. Delta is also like that. Mercedes Benz, if you see, these are all the things. I have to design a logo and I have to do a best for our things. And when you see Cisco, if you see Cisco, if you see HP, see vertical lines formula is like that. Cisco have a vertical lines, aggressive strength. HP is same way. IBM, AT&T, DHL, horizontal lines, triangulate income, community. So these are the things. DHL, this is a courier service. DHL, if you see what type of things they are going to involve in this one. AT&T. That is something circle types of things. IBM lines, horizontal lines. Okay. If you see Bench, if you see the benchmark, that is the Bench logo. If you see the Fruity, if you see Coca-Cola, if you see Olympics type of things. So these are all the things which reputation is there. Negative space. Space around the object brings balance to the aircraft. Nike Air Max. So when we go for shoes, we have to speak about the technology of the shoe, how much comfort it is for me. Okay. Hierarchy and proportion, size and scale, size elements dramatically large or small to focus on key aspects of our design of the product. So Magneto, open source e-commerce is there. You can purchase from there. And the size elements dramatically large or small to focus on key aspects of our design. Okay. Symmetric and texture. So target, these are all logos, what we have to do. So if I have my own, see the McDonald's logo, McDonald's KF symbol. So these are all the things what we have to put in our mind when we go for the entrepreneurship. So image placeholder is one part in which you can create a logo. Now the 3D printing is there. You can go in that one and you can bring it a very beautiful logo, and that logo will be permanent. So that logo reflects all the things. Materials and manufacturing methods. What is that one? Definition of DFM. Design for Mac. Very, very important point in any industry, any startups or any entrepreneurship. Design for manufacturing. Early cost estimation should be there and product simplification should be there. Definition of DFM. The goal of DFM analysis is to determine what a product should really cost to make. Okay. As the basis for engineering studies to provide guidance to the design team in simplifying the product, reducing manufacturing, assembling cost to quality, quantify improvements. This is the number one part. Number two is as a benchmark tool to study competitors. Benchmark means nowadays ISO 2000, 9000, 10000 is going on. That is known as a benchmark. Benchmark tool to study competitors' product and to quantify. Manufacturing and assembling difficulties is there. As a tool to help validate design concepts, provide cost predictions and to negotiate suppliers' bids and contracts. Engineering, that is speed to market, favor engineering chances, better use of time. Engineering spends more time towards product manufacturable, less time taking changes to product during manufacturing phases. Lessons library, changes are documented, it should be documented, put it in the library such that we can study, anyone can read it, and anyone can make it their own simplification seeing that document. Okay, can be analyzed and improved. Improved creativity. You can improve your creativity with what if tool. What if the question comes that if, what if is there, I have to identify. Manufacturing. So DFM promotes earlier involvement of manufacturing design, take advantage of manufacturing knowledge, design out of the product process, production process. Speed to market is the products are produced more quickly due to streamlined manufacturing process. If we don't have a streamlined manufacturing process, we can't get a good product. So streamline is very important when we see the manufacturing process. The team, very, very important point, improved cross team cooperation, provide metrics for discussion, tools for concurrent engineering. What I do when I use my startup, I have my own startup, two is fully running and one is partially. And we have the engineers and I involve the students also to do that one. So what I do, you know, when the startup have one product, I ask the people to criticize in that one. Let them find the criticism in that part. And before launching that, all criticism, I have to address it and I have to put it in my prototype. And then I have to go for the launch as a product. So world-class product development and manufacturing. Product design and production is more structured, measurable, efficient, reduced cost. I already told you cost is a very, very important point for any customer. So it should be a reduced part. More competitive. More competitive means in the market, suppose if you take a soap, number of soaps are there. So how you are going to sell your soap? Suppose I am going to bring one soap as a Keshav soap. So Keshav soap should be in the market. So how should be that soap? It should be a competent to Lux, Dove, Hamam, Mysore Sandal. Number of soaps are there. So the unique part should reflect there. The unique part should be there in my soap such that it should be competent with the market. It means it should be different from the other same product. Other but same product. Overseas is outstanding and DFM. What is this very tricky part when we go in the marketing part? DFM can find savings in material and manufacturing that can more than make up for labor cost differences. Lowered risks, keeping costly engineering changes, manufacturing local avoids, communications and cultural roadblocks. The costs and risks of quality problems. Outsourcing is high shipping costs, patent infringement. So these are all things what we have to do it. Overseas outsourcing and DFM. When I outsource the thing, for example, suppose I make one product and the components I am going to outsource. For example, computers. Monitor is from another company. Keyboard is other company. Mouse is other company. But when I assemble, my total product will be there, but it is outsourced. Everything is outsourced. So products are easier to manufacture. Okay, reducing long distance engineering changes. Overseas suppliers can be held to best practice, cost, material, assembly methods. Now, the beauty is in Anantapur, there is a Kia Motors, which came 3 years back. You know, the Kia Motors have a sub factories nearby, 10 sub factories, which produces screws, bolts, all the things. Why we go here and there? Why not we put it this sub part which I need nearby me? That is the problem. That is the concept. To reduce the pricing, to reduce the engineering, to reduce the long distance engineering changes. Okay, that can be done. And the streamlined design to manufacture is a very important point. It can reduce communication problems and a lot of things. Now, about 75 to 80% of quality issues during mass productions are due to design. If the design is correct, you will get 80% a satisfaction level. 75 to 80% satisfaction, it means quality or as per the quality. Design for manufacturing aims to reduce material, overhead and labor cost, shorten the product, development cycle, focus on standard to reduce. For example, automation. It will reduce the human interference in that one. It will reduce the time because from one place I can go for e-office and I can send my file to my subordinate. I can send my file to the higher officials for the approval and I can get it back from them. Sitting in one place, no need to move here and there. Okay, so this is the design process. It means if your design is good, nearly 75 to 80% you are going to be succeed in that product. Conceptual analysis, redesign, conclusion. Conceptual is the thing. With the concept, you are going to make it a design and you are thinking of the product. In that one, I have to think about affordable, attractive and all the things. When I come to analysis part is components process, component moving, component requirement, whether it is available here or not, whether I have to use a foreign type of components or not. These all things involved in analysis. Redesigning, for these questions, we go for suspect components and processes should be identified. And conclusion is redesigning. We have to go for the redesign. Okay. Then reports, evaluation, tests, okay? And then key principles of DFM process, minimize part count, standardize parts and material complexity, create modular assemblies, design for efficient joining, minimize reorientation of parts during assembling or machining, simplify and reduce the number of manufacturing operations, specify acceptable surface finishes for a functionality. These are the key parts. Minimize for part count. You can see this. I have given a rough sketch in the left side. And you go for this one. That is the right side. See, all the bolts and things are there. So if suppose something is wrong, I have to open the total things like that. This is the part. This is the thing what I am going to do it. See all these things. If any one is going, I am going to use it again. And then I have to come to this one. So this is minimize part count. Part count should be less. It's not more than. Here, what is that? This four leg. If it is dispendable, no problem. I can remove it. I can put it. But more and more parts should not be there. Okay. Complexity. The cars, if you see the cars here. Tire to 10 million plant, common part. R&D part is there. This is a very famous Japanese person who used the Toyota company CEO. Everyone knows him. And the Toyota company has first used the fuzzy logic and artificial intelligence in their company to make the output as good as better. Okay, so very successful Toyota motor company, which have captured nearly 70% at that time. Last, if you say 10 years back, 70% of the market is captured by this Toyota. Okay. Create modular assemblers. What is that? All components can be removed as single pieces, which assist with servicing and troubleshooting with a portable. The word portable I can use. So assembling means it's not like that. I can disassemble it. I can put it in my pocket. And again, I can assemble and make it a car and I can go on that one. So this should be a process. This is a very, what you say, simpler manner, how I can get it my product. So this all things we have to think. For example, if you see both the thing that is flexible, that you have to make it up and down, screw based, and this is a spring based. So very slight modification, you are going to satisfy more and more customer rather than that one. Design for joining. What is that one? Snap fit is there. If you see the fitting, increasing cost is there. So I have to use a very less amount and I have to be a good fit. So this is the thing. Assembling part should be there. So if you see the assembling part, see, part can hang up. Why? Because it's not fit. So when you see the right side of this figure, this is the best way. Part falls into place, then this is the best fit for that one. Like that, I have to check it each and every part before assembling the things. Now, simplify and manufacturing operations. So what is learned manufacturing operations? Half empty, half full is a manufacturing operation model. Model T is there. And thinker is, can I reduce the glass half the size? That is the thinking of the thinker. The glass is given and a T is given. If you want to reduce the T, what you are going to think? The glass can be reduced. No, T can be reduced. So if you think the T can be reduced, it is in our hand. If you say glass is reduced, it is not in our hand. Okay. So these are the things. When you see the plumbing system, this type of valve is there. So this type of valve became very popular rather than the taps what we have in the ancient time or some 10 to 15 years back model. The DFM difference is up to 80% of the cost of a new part is locked in during the early design phases. So DFM not only allows pure costing of material and manufacturing technique, but also gives alternate manufacturing process, and they may not be familiar with that one. So that is the DFM beauty. And the average, if you see the DFM cases, labor cost, part cost, separate fasteners, weight, assembly part, assembly time, assembly cost, assembly tools, assembly operations, product development cycle, tool cost. Now, you know, the iPhone is also now these days doing what? Outsourcing of the things is doing by the iPhone also now these days. Now, start three parts, requires a squirrel drilling, needs careful alignment. This is the start part. Then finishing part is two parts integrated faster and cradle. Can be handled, pressed into place even by end customer and can be removed. So this is the start and this is the finish part. So start to finish part, if you see, this is going to start here. This is the second stage. This is the third, fourth, fifth. This is the finished part now. Okay. Now, gathering DFM information. Sketches, drawing product specifications and design alternative. A detailed understanding of production and assembly process is there. Estimation of manufacturing cost, production volumes and ramp-up timing will be there. This is the flow. If you see this flow, you can understood all the things. What is the flow? Proposal design and accepted design. Between that, lot of things is going on. What is that? Estimation, reduce the cost assembling, reduce the cost when production, consider the input of DFM, and then go to the good enough and go to the acceptable design. Once you propose the design, whether it is accepted or not, it depends on the total things what you have, what you are seeing in this one. This all things is going to be play an important role for that one. Okay, so estimation and accounting is there. So this is the manufacturing system, and if you see all the sides, costs, finished raw materials, up and down this costs, and energy supply service is there, and the final output is finishing goods comes from all these things. This is the diagram for the manufacturing system, and if you see the product, manufacturing cost, and it is going to divide into component, assembly, overhead, and the last raw material, processing and processing tool. So when we say the standard part, it go on like that. So this is the manufacturing cost depends on. Manufacturing cost or a product. Okay. So component, assembly, overhead is there. So fixed cost versus variable cost. These are all the today there is something change, I can reduce my cost or I can increase my cost. If you say no, it is not like that, you are fixing your price, then it is very difficult, then we are loser in the market. Now reducing a component, understanding, redesigning, appropriate economic scale, standardized components process, black box type of component part, these are all the things which we have to put in our mind when we go for the reducing part. Cost driven is same thing, processing steps are the same things, past processes are the same thing, economic scale, standard component analysis tools we have to see, assembling is the another part. Okay, enough parts are there, integrating parts are there, we have to integrate. Okay, minimize ease of assembly, how to minimize the assembling. If assembling is more and more, I am not going to purchase that product because I have to purchase and then I have to assemble. If it is one or two steps, it is easy for me, then I am going to buy it and assemble it. Customer assemble, production is there, then proofreading for the product. Okay, so these are design for production general principle. The first part in the business is the common sense. Why people are neglecting now these days? A common sense is a very, very, it's very less contribution, but very powerful tool which gives output beauty. Common sense, plan define, availability, tools availability, worker skill available. Workers are there, but they are not skilled. No use. So worker skills availability, employee simplicity, standardization. Okay. So these are all the guidelines. If you see anywhere 1 to 13, these are all the guidelines when we design the product guidelines. Types, prototypes, prototypes uses, principle of the prototype. 3D computer modeling is there. Freeform 3D fabrication is there. Rapid prototype. I can go for 3D printing now these days. Okay. So these are all the things which plays a very important role. I go for the thing. And we can go for online experimental plan. Why? Because see the pandemic situation. If I sit ideal, I am a loser. If online experiment plan is there, I can go in this pandemic also. Online experiment, use prototype for experimentation and go online and check it your plan. Okay, so procurement method, construction, testing, lot of things can be done here. Alpha prototypes, beta prototypes, production prototypes are there. Okay, these are all the examples you can see. See the examples. Assembling, how much time it will take. Like that, this is taken from the companies. Okay, goals, very important. Vision and missions are very important for any company or any startup. We should be put in a very conscious way. Final designing, high portability. PC manufacturer or retailers. Okay, PC manufacturers, this is the thing, what I say as an example, going to put it in that one, okay, that is personal computer. So see the raw part, these all things, but when we see the new computer comes to the home, it doesn't appear this all things, but when you see in the production style, these all things play a very important role. Every circuit is playing an important role. Okay. Motorcycles, for example, if you take, that also same thing. It depends on design, because I have to see the data. Why I told that data has to be squeezed, data has to be studied. Because if I built a bike which is not fit for the youth, but 80% of the population is youth, my product will be useless. This is by Harley Davidson. Okay, he told about all the things about cost reduction and so. After analyzing, laboratory instrument is there. Okay, so these are all the things what we are going to see in this one. Laboratory instrument, how much material we can cut it, how to make it, what is the time period. These all things we are going to see in our design. Okay, so let's talk about your product. If you are a student, your product is there, you have to take these steps. You have to take a measure of these steps. Minimize number of parts, favor parts and assembling drawings, less complicated assemblies, favor parts to hold to required QC, quality control, favor parts to fail, minimize number of part numbers, favor vibrations of like parts. Making assembly process easy and error proofed, ensure parts cannot be assembled wrong, make it bluntly obvious when parts are missing, ensure assembly tooling in design into part, ensure parts are self-securing, force fitting of parts should be there, use repeatedly well understood process, quality is easy to control, assembly quality is easy to control, choose parts that service process operations, less damage to parts, less degradation of parts, design and adequate testing, tougher to mistake good or bad product and vice versa. These are all the steps you have to put in your mind when you are going to make your own product. Packing and labeling is the another level of thinking that we have to take care. Okay, CE level, FCC level, ISI standard, FDA certification, pricing models are there. We have to see of that one also. And then we are going to make it cost, marketing, profiting, direct cost, indirect cost, GST is indirect cost. You know, now these days GST is added now. So see, lot of things I have to take. If suppose someone is going to say, I am going to give you a product without GST or including GST, that there is a very difference in the marketing part. Model, market-based model, value-based model. Okay, these are all the things what we have to put in our mind such that we can get our product. So product liability is there. Will be failure. Experimental perspective, regulation, suppliers, stakeholders, costs. Okay. As a startup, you need to be careful. Very, very careful. Why? These principles were developed for a large established mass production company. You don't go for mass production company. You go for your own startup. It should be in the base level, and you start with the prototype. And does you think whether this will add to the value or not? Yes or no? Then you go ahead. Lean manufacture. Okay, these are all the things what we have to put when we go for a startup thing. So bottom one to bottom two. Okay. Variation from requirements is there. Priorities and successful products will be there. So these are the things total what I want to speak on the from a product to total marketing type. So prototype to product, that is my talk, prototype to product. So I think I have taken some 5 or 10 minutes more in my lecture. So now it's a time you can ask anything about any prototype or any startup type or any entrepreneurs. Thank you for giving me this opportunity to speak to you people and to make my knowledge about the startup to make you learn. Thank you very much. Madam.
Sir, thank you, sir. Wait a minute, sir.
I am
Shiva Parvati wants to talk. I have to unmute her.
Sir, this lecture is very elaborated, sir. Elaborated and so many modules are there in the process when a prototype to product, sir. Because these are the terms, it is very difficult to understand for me also because as a theoretical maths.
Madam, excuse me. Just I will tell you. See, when a person is going to be a perfect man or woman, perfect, what is the process? We are taking birth. From birth, we are going to grow. It's a very complicated and very beautiful process. Yes. Every value, every idea is going to add it in every stage. If anything is missing, we can deviate from our values. We can deviate from our job. We may be a thief. We may be a dacoit. We may be a collector. We may be an engineer. Yes, we may be a scientist. So same process in the product. Same process we have to give to the product. And that product will be successful when we are going to take care of all these things.
Very interesting, sir. Lecture is very interesting and it is full of knowledge with interesting things, sir. And every module, you should specify that which method we can use to solve this type of module. So, very interesting, sir. Queries from the participant side, please. Anybody want to ask question? We will unmute you.
Yeah. Question or share your experience or your interaction. You can interact.
Okay.
No problem. You can ask questions. You can interact or easy. You can make it share your experience in this regard.
Okay.
Students, I request you to utilize this opportunity. You might have number of ideas. If you have any doubts you want to discuss with sir, it's a very nice platform. You should utilize this one. Sir, from my side, I want to ask you one particular question, sir.
Madam, please.
I have been associated with this ISS since 2 years. I'm from pharmacy background.
Okay.
I was really very happy when I came to know that you're from mathematics background and you're doing so much of work towards this entrepreneurship and startups. So the participants in our group, they are really first year students who have just begun.
Okay.
Even when I was interacting with the maths department, they asked me, you're from the basic science group. How do you expect us to develop as an entrepreneur or how do you expect us to convert into a startup? You have an interesting story of any student or a person who has floated his own startup.
Yeah, why not? Yes, madam. My one student, Sai Krishna Reddy, is there. He one of the affiliated college to JNTU, he was doing his BTech. So while he's doing his BTech, I was controller of examination at that time, 2011. When he passed out the BTech, he get it something 45% in the BTech. He came to me and asked that, sir, what to do? I have a very less percentage, 45%. What to do? How can I get a job in like this? So I thought for a while. Why he approached me for some recommendation to get it anyhow great above 50. So rather than saying him that, no, you can't get it, you are waste, What I told, okay, fine. What you are doing? What is your passion? He told that I built this one. He showed number of prototypes. Then I told, when you have this all type of ideas, you are doing like this, why not you convert into an entrepreneur? Why you are saying 45-50%? What is the now? You can have an entrepreneurship. Then what he told, facilities in the sponsored quota. So what he joined as MTech Power Systems. And after 1 year, he joined in one of the company in Bangalore. He has not completed MTech also. He is not complete. But now he is doing a wonderful job in IoT, Internet of Things. He is now a leading person for all companies for IoT-based platform. He is in Bangalore now. So what I am saying, when you see in a pen or paper, he is not good. But his common sense, if you see something, if you give something now, he will take 5 minutes time to browse all the things to understand what is what, and then he will explain the total theory of that one to you. For example, if suppose you give some system, computer, how I have to open, he will sit for 5 minutes, he will open all, he will browse all the things, and then he will tell you total about that system to you, that like this, you can go like this. So pinpoint towards that work or towards that idea, towards the common sense he is using, that is the beauty he has. And now he is a very leading professional in one of the company in Bangalore. He is an IoT-based platform, man.
Yes. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, madam. Thank you very much.
I request Dr. D. Sujata to propose Vota.
It gives me immense pleasure to be a part of this program. As a, though it is formal, I want to say that I want to extend my heartfelt thanks to our management, Vice Chancellor, beloved Vice Chancellor, Professor Duggur Jamuna Garu, and our Registrar Mamata Garu, who have been always a support behind us, who motivates us to kind take up all of these activities apart from our regular works. I thank them for providing this opportunity for the IIC, to be part of IIC. I thank, my special thanks to the today's speaker, Professor Keshav Reddy, sir. It is really my pleasure to meet you today on this virtual platform, sir, because it was really worthwhile listening to your presentation, where you have been talking a lot about how to convert a prototype into a product. Because this might definitely help the students who really want to pursue their career in entrepreneurship, because you have explained in every detail, each and every step where they have to focus. Especially the most important aspect was, I was very keenly listening, but how you are mentioning about those logos. The design of the logo you mentioned was really good. So I hope the students will learn from this. This skills, what you have presented today, may not be only for entrepreneurship, but whenever they do any research, it will be very useful for them. So our heartfelt thanks from my side and from our IIC for spending your valuable time with us. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you, madam.
Thank you very much, sir.
I also want to thank Department of Mathematics, Dr. Shiva Parvati and Dr. Venkat Lakshmi Garu, for taking the initiation, and they are the people who brought you onto this platform. So I thank the people for bringing such a nice, wonderful speaker for the session. And I look forward that we will be associating in many other, many more venues, sir, to definitely take ahead the startup and entrepreneurship. Not the least, I thank all the participants for their patience listening, not only on the Zoom, but also on the YouTube platform. Thank you once again, and we'll be meeting many more times like this to keep us engaged in the journey of startup and entrepreneurship. Thank you once again. And especially the command center people who arrange all kind of virtual meetings for us. My special thanks to them. They are overworked, they are overworking, they have lots of burden on them, but still they were able to arrange this meeting in a very short notice. Thank you, people of the command center. And once again, thank you very much, sir. It was my pleasure meeting you today. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you for Sri Padmavati Mahila University, Department of Mathematics. And I am a mathematics background, but my passion is like, therefore, I accepted to give this talk because I am involved in this one. Thank you, madam. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Can I leave now?
Yes, sir. Yes. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Yes.
Thank you.
Shiva, manam wait cheyali. Pillalandaru leave enta varaku. The participants can leave, ma. Thank you for your presence. Venkat Lakshmi garu unnara?
Unnaru, but